What's up, guys? Clayton Fioriti here. Now today, I wanted to talk about some of the early concept art that was done for the last MonsterVerse film. This is how Ghidorah almost looked in Godzilla, King of the Monsters. So when it comes to the production of all kaiju films, the monsters in question usually go through a number of different iterations. Even Godzilla himself received a small makeover in the case of both his legs and dorsal spines in the new movie. While these changes were admittedly subtle and most people probably wouldn't have been able to pick up on them, others were far more abstract in nature, such as this concept art that would have radically changed the physical features of Toho's iconic three-headed space dragon. Here we can see that the filmmakers behind King of the Monsters look to have been going for a much more serpentine design early on in production. From the long length of the snake-like tongue to the elongated fangs that resemble several slithering species, here Ghidorah looks to be resembling something much more akin to Primal Rage's Vertigo than the Asian-inspired dragon that we've all come to know and love. I'd also like to point out that the general design of the neck on Ghidorah here seems to look as if it's spread out like some kind of cobra that can be found in the real world. Whatever the case may be, I actually think that it makes for one hell of a cool creature, and to be honest with you, I personally prefer it over what we got in the final film. Another piece of early Ghidorah art shows us just how abstract and monstrous the alien almost was. Sporting a pretty puny eye that sits towards the back of the creature's jawline, and a little nose that looks surprisingly mammalian when compared to everything else on its disturbing body. For those of you unaware, this design was drawn up by concept artist Ken Barthelemy. His interpretation of the monster obviously would have come with a few purist fans feeling a bit unfamiliar with the character, but again, I gotta say that I, for one, really do enjoy the fun ideas that are going on here. When it comes to the evolution of Ghidorah, specifically in Toho's Godzilla franchise, he's actually undergone a massive amount of physical redesigns and transformations over the years. Our initial look of the creature may have been far more inspired by Asian dragons, yes, but just flash forward to the fascinating Cretaceous Ghidorah from the late 90s, and you get a design that both stays true to the terrifying monster while also forging its own identity in a fun and bold new way. If Godzilla King of the Monsters had gone with this redesign of the character, I actually think it would have made me like the movie even more, because it would have really presented a separate identity for the character that we'd yet to see in an American adaptation. It also would have lined up much more with the aesthetic that I think was started in this continuity with creatures like the Mutos in Gareth Edwards' Godzilla film, which admittedly don't look all that cool, but I do see some overlap between them and this more monstrous looking interpretation of the three-headed dragon. This is supposed to be a creature that comes from outer space after all, and I for one am all for them going in the more bizarre and fantastical direction of something as nonsensical as a giant gravity beam spitting serpent from space. But anyways, those are all just my own thoughts on the subject matter. What do you guys think? Would you have preferred this design of Ghidorah over what we got in the final film? Or are you really content with what was in King of the Monsters? Whatever your own thoughts may be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below.